Hi guys, I just want to bring you a very short tutorial on how I make my journaling spots to go into my micro minis. First thing you need to do is grab yourself some paper. In my case, I'm just going to use some coffee stain paper. My favourite product, dare I say it, now that I have one, is a quilter square, but this can be done with a ruler. You are going to cut off a piece of paper 1.5 inches wide by 3.25 in length. So I would use my quilter's rule, line it up, take a pencil and just literally draw around. In my case I need to, because I'm just using a scrap of paper, send that across like so. And that would be, I've just cut out using a pair of old-fashioned scissors. Once you've cut your piece of paper out, for the tutorial I've just used a pencil and marked across. So we have got, you can use a scoreboard. If you are using a scoreboard, you want to measure 6/8, then 1.5 inches, and then 1 inch, and score accordingly. In my case, I just do everything by eye. I haven't got a scoreboard to hand. I've already folded and emphasised using a bit of vintage photo where the score lines are. Your 6/8 is going to be your top, 1.5 is the centre, so your 1 inch is the bottom here. And you can see the little envelope beginning to form, or the journaling spot. This is at this point you can make a decision if you want to leave it with square edges or if you're going to use a corner punch. I'm going to corner punch the top, which is the 6/8, and that's how it will look. You can yet again make a decision if you're going to corner round off the bottom, and this is the 1 inch section. So now we have our little journaling spot. If I was going to turn this into an envelope, I'd have left the corners dead straight, and I've used some tacky glue, and I would have just run a small proportion of glue down the outer edge. But we're going to leave this as a journaling spot. But what I like is, rather than them expanding and opening up whilst in the journal, if you take a few more minutes just to make a little stopper. This one's made out of card, so it's just a little bit and it hasn't been folded. There we go. And then that will keep that nicely and neatly shut in your journal. All you need then is a punch of your choice. In my case, I chose the flower. I've got one here, slightly distressed up, just in the same coffee paper as before. Just be aware of your, where you have made your fold and where you're going to stick your little punch on. My suggestion would be, at this point, just take a pencil. I'm just going to try and tuck half of it under and half of it glued, and I'm going to make a little pencil mark on my work, and that gives me an idea of where I'm actually going to glue my flower. Said, taking a little bit of tacky glue, glue up just half. You don't need a lot. Tacky glue is a good sticky product. So that's half my little, well, just a few dobs on there. Turn the flower over. The glue section is going on the 1 inch panel. Remember, we put that little pencil mark to give us a guide. So stick it down just over the pencil mark, and then centre it up if need be, and then you are going to get that section tucked under. This is still wet, so it's not going to stick straight away and hold it, but once that is dry, that will hold that journaling tag in very nicely. nicely, ready for it to be glued on the back into your journal. Hope that helped, guys. I'll catch up with you later. Bye-bye.